This is nerve-wracking. One would think because I'm an actress, this is easy for me. Lies. Lies. Someone said I should breathe in and out. That's not working. So, first of all, I'd like to say good morning, ladies and gentlemen. The guests, class of 007. I don't know why I'm doing that. I know why I'm doing that, but 007. The teachers and our principal. It's been 10 years already. I feel old. No offense to the old girls. No offense. I have a few memories, well, a lot, but I have one in specific, more than one. It's my Costa class with Miss Dante. I know, right? So, my Costa class, people would sleep when I was reading. I'm not sure what happened then, Mr. Dells. But 2 weeks, into my Costa class, all I was thinking was, abort a mission, abort, just drop it, drop and leave. Then I was like, no, but Afrikaans, I can't, so. But hey, here we are on Zanzi Magic with two shows, Isithunzi and Isisikizi. Fluently speaking Isixhosa, and we're better now. My math class. Yes, Unati Math is like, oh no. I know. Math class. The thing is with math, right? See, if you have the right answer, but you don't know how you got to the right answer. Just drop it. That's what happened to me most of the time. I got the right answer, né? But when I was asked to explain, it wouldn't work. It wouldn't work. There's one specific. Oh, then there's Chisi Flay with Ms. Ferreira. Hey, I still don't know how to make that. But hey, Chisi Flay, 007 home egg. If you still remember. Okay, never mind. Anyway, there's one particular activity that I think that's the reason why I'm here for. It's drama with Ms. Jean. I love stage. When I was still in primary school at VP. And if I wasn't in the production, I was watching a production. I fell in love with stage because I'm an introvert, right? I'm shy. Yes, I am. I'm very shy. And I'm socially awkward. So I fell in love with drama, with stage, because it was an escape for me. I could be someone else. And I remember Ms. G telling me that, you know what, you can be anything you want to be. And I kept that. There's one particular story I played yesterday. Remember, Ms. G? I played yesterday. Yesterday is a film, right? A South African film played by Lele Tikumalo. And I played it on stage here at River College. And the next day, my grandfather was famous. Like, I don't understand. Like, everyone, the teachers, the staff, front staff, kept on calling him yesterday's grandfather. I just didn't understand. But he believed that he was famous. Shout out to him, may his soul rest in peace. You guys can make me cry, don't do that. For stage for me, right, is where I discovered my skill, my talent, and myself. That I could be whatever I wanted to be and do whatever I wanted to do. Well, desired. Whatever I desired to be and do. The experience of walking into people's shoes and people's lives and sharing it with the viewers, that's my life. I love it and I'll always love it. And it hasn't been easy, right? I have to say, getting here and being here as an actress, for me, it's only the beginning. But what has kept me going and what keeps me going is, one, be a visionary. Have a vision board. That works. You guys know what's a vision board, right? Okay, you take magazines and you cut out pictures, right? The things that you like. Quotes, words, kind of, yes, hi.
Yes, hi.
I don't know, chicken. And then you post them up, make a collage, and put them where you can see the pictures, right? Can be words, colors, the things that you want, what you aspire to be, and you look at that every day, right? You meditate, you look at it. First, you must be grateful, right? You can't just ask God for everything. You need to be grateful and say, thank you, God, shout out to you. So you look at it and you say thank you, and you receive those things without receiving them physically. So you look at it and you say, thank you that I've received this and this and this and this, and I will be this and this and this, whatever you want to be. That works. So be a visionary, have intention, be intentional in your life. Sorry, gosh. Believe in yourself. Second of all, believe in yourself. That has carried me a long way, especially in the industry that I'm in. It's very competitive. You know, everyone is trying to make it. But if you believe in yourself, then people can believe in you. Be kind to yourself. We tend to forget ourselves. Yes, I remembered what I wrote in the trick. Be kind and be gentle to yourself. Take care of yourself, take care of your body, take care of your mind, take care of your spirit, right? And know that you're enough, especially for women, especially for girls, young girls. Know that you are enough. Don't try to be something else or someone else. God has you here for a reason, and I'm a living example of that. As I've said, it's a very competitive industry that I'm in as an actress, but I keep it going and I believe, and sometimes you have to fake it. You know, like, okay, never mind. So, and today I'm standing in front of you as a guest speaker, which I'm very honored. Thank you very much for having me here. Thank you for awarding me the opportunity to speak to young ladies. Hopefully I have strengthened those who wanted to give up or feel like blessings or success has favoritism. No, it doesn't. You can be what you want to be and desire to be. And don't forget yourself. And know that you are beautiful. Like, for real. Like, know that you are beautiful. Shout out to the choir, hey? Yo, guys, touch me. Otherwise, thank you so much, ladies. Thank you, gentlemen. Thank you, guys.